Let's have a look at the digestive system from anterior to posterior. And so anteriorly, that is from the mouth. Okay, so after a swallow, we're gonna have material going down the esophagus. So we've already seen that in the neck. Okay, the esophagus is gonna pass behind, because again, because it's a dorsal structure, behind all of these circulatory structures, behind the respiratory structures. And we will see it now. And there's the thoracic esophagus right here. My hand might be in the way, right there. Okay, now we have another tube here connected by connective tissue. That's gonna be the aorta. That's a major blood vessel. Okay, we'll get to that in another tour, but that's the thoracic esophagus, and that thoracic esophagus is gonna pass through, right, the structure here, the diaphragm. Okay, it's gonna come behind the structure right here, the liver. You've seen that already. Okay, and actually, as we lift the liver up, okay, we can see where the esophagus is gonna end and dump the material then into the stomach, okay, this pouch. And of course, because this is a fetal pig, it's never eaten, so the stomach is developed, but it's never been used yet, okay? And again, alongside the stomach, we have the circulatory structure, the spleen, all right? And so the stomach is large and sac-like. In this case, it's empty. And you can tell the distal end of the stomach, distal relative to the mouth, okay, the downstream end is gonna be this really, really thick knot. Look at me, I'm squeezing. It might be shadowy. There, I'm squeezing that, and it's not compressing, even though like that is super compressible. This is not, because it's a knot of smooth muscle, and it's called the pyloric sphincter. And so just like the round muscle around your lips that can purse your mouth closed, that sphincter will purse closed the exit from the stomach, okay, controlling what goes into the duodenum. Okay, we'll do that in the next tour. All right, see you then.